Well, hello everybody, and welcome to singing our favorite hymns. It's Tuesday night, and usually I do our recording in the mornings, but I've been busy all day, and seems like every time I would come to the study to sit down and start, something would come up. And so all is well tonight, all is quiet in the study, and the only person in here with me is not a person, but my cat Oscar, and he's sound asleep over in the corner, so I don't think we'll have any interruptions tonight. The hymn we're going to share today or tonight is a request by my good friend Betty Fulton, and it's an old hymn that I know all of us have memories of, an old hymn that just is special to all of us, In the Garden. And I'll tell you a little bit of the story. It was written by a man named Charles Austin Miles, who grew up and became a pharmacist. And somewhere early in those years as a pharmacist, he left pharmacy and wrote his first hymn and published that first hymn and ended up becoming editor and manager of the publishing company that had published his first hymn. He was also a church choir director, and he was an amateur photographer. And the story behind the song is special. Back in, he was born in 1868. In 1912, one day he was in his dark room waiting for some film to develop, and he had a profound spiritual experience where he had an incredible a vision of Mary Magdalene visiting the empty tomb. And he saw her leave and go to a garden where she met the Master and heard him speak her name. When he came to himself from that awesome experience, the words to the song were in his mind and heart, and he got them down on paper as quick as he could. And that night, he wrote the music. The song was published and became a theme song of the Billy Sunday evangelistic crusades. I'm always about to say Billy Graham, but it was back then during Billy Sunday's days and crusades. He wrote about his hymn writing, and this is what he said. He said, "It is as a writer of the gospel of gospel songs that I am proud to be known, for in that way I may be of the most use to my Master, whom I serve willingly, although not as efficiently as is my desire." And we know that In the Garden remains a favorite hymn for all of us who treasure that quiet time in the garden with our Savior. And so I look forward to us singing it together. We're going to sing the first and the second verses, because I think those are the ones, they're three verses, but the first two are the ones that we probably are most familiar with. So, I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the sun discloses, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy share as we tarry. has ever known. And you remember the second verse, he speaks and the sound of his voice is so sweet the birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart is ringing. He speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet, the birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart is ringing, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. Well, that's just beautiful, the lyrics and the music. And I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. What a wonderful way to end this day in the garden and just being there with our Savior and knowing that He's with us there too. So what a wonderful old hymn. And I just hope that it has lifted you today and has blessed you. And we're going to say until the next time, God bless you, and keep on a singing, for Jesus is always the song in our heart.